to the ball, be aggressive, and make things happen up front.
I thought the guys came in well prepared from summer conditioning. Coach Pittman, his staff, did a great job getting these guys physically stronger.
I think that our focus was there, and obviously we had a very physical fall camp, so I think that showed definitely in the game too.
I thought it was one of our more difficult camps that we had. They responded, they attacked it, and certainly that showed up as we prepared for the Lafayette game and went to play.
But overall, up to where we are right now, some really good things and some really good competition. Now we got to make some tough decisions and go back and watch tape.
For the 2 weeks of preparation we had, we did a great job of coming out every day with good focus and good intensity.
This week we did some indoor practices with the heat on in the indoor and a little bit of humidity going in there as well.
Walk and spin.
I'm already sweating.
Try to get the temperature about as hot as we possibly could. I think we got up to 92 degrees and 62% humidity.
Our strength staff, trainers, and coaches did a good job of having us adapt here in Boise too by heating up the indoor, getting the humidity up in there. We knew what we had to accomplish. No one was shocked by the heat, and it was very efficient.
I think we practiced really well, and I think it really translated over into the game. We played assignment sound football in practice, which was huge.
It's going to be it for the week. It's going to be win the one-on-ones. Win the one-on-one.
Snatch him up, snatch him up.
Everyone knew exactly what they were supposed to do.
We're going to go there a day early, get acclimated, get ready to play at 10 to 11 a.m.
That was really good for us, I think, to get out on Friday and practiced right when we would be playing the game. And you know, one thing that we had prepared for back here was the humidity and the heat, and really focusing on hydration, making sure nobody was going to be cramping up or anything like that.
But tomorrow's about being 1-0. Visualize your teammates doing their part as well. Take 10 minutes to visualize the game tomorrow. When we wake up, it's time to play.
Mindset was kind of forget about any of the factors that we couldn't control. We couldn't control the humidity, the heat, and kind of stuff like that. And I think people really zeroed in on what the goal was.
You know, walking through that tunnel onto the field, no one was hesitant. No one was, you know, everyone was 100% into it. We knew we had prepared the way we should have. You know, the confidence was definitely there.
What a play on fourth down by Jonathan Moxey. Wide open is Spurbeck. Splits defenders. He'll get inside the five and get down to the 2-yard line. Jennings gets knocked down, fourth sack of the day. Handoff, McNichols, he walks in untouched. Nichols left side, huge hole, and he gets into the end zone. Second touchdown for McNichols.
We had some unbelievable individual effort, guys. I got all these stats here, and I'm not going to talk about any single one of them because that doesn't matter. It's all about the team. It's all about the team, and it's all about the team getting out there and playing together, because it takes every single guy on that football field to accomplish what we did today.
Go Hawks! Go Big Blue! Fight! Fight! BSU!